मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, एज आई सेड लेट अस डिस्कस सर्टेन एक्सपेरिमेंट्स ऑफ लाइफ प्रोसेस चैप्टर। इन द लास्ट टू क्लासेस आई हैव एक्सप्लेन्ड द आंसर्स ऑफ फर्स्ट प्री बोर्ड एग्जाम। नाउ लेट अस डिस्कस द एक्टिविटी दैट डेमॉन्स्ट्रेट्स chlorophyll is essential for photosynthesis. Activity that demonstrates chlorophyll is essential for Chlorophyll is essential for photosynthesis. For this activity, what we need to do? First, we have to take a potted plant with variegated leaves. So, take a potted plant like this. A potted plant which is having variegated leaves. Variegated leaves means like patches of different colors. So like this, patches of different colors having potted plant you are taking. That is growing in a pot. Right? Variegated leaves. Example for such variegated leaves having plant is croton plant, money plant. So we have taken a potted plant with variegated leaves. This plant you have to keep it in dark room for 3 days so that all the starch gets used up. Why all the starch gets used up? Starch is the storage polysaccharide, storage form of carbohydrates. Starch is the storage form of carbohydrate in plants. So, as photosynthesis is carried out, glucose is produced and which is converted into starch and it is getting stored in the plant body. When there is no photosynthesis, the stored carbohydrate is utilized up. When you keep this plant in dark for 3 days, under the dark condition, as there is no light, photosynthesis cannot be carried out. So entire starch will get used up. So that all starch will get used up. Now keep this plant in sunlight for about 6 hours. The variegated leaves having plant, it was kept for 3 days in dark and starch was completely getting used up during that time. Now we have taken out this plant and you have kept this plant in under sunlight for about 6 hours. Take out a leaf, that is pluck a leaf from the plant. Now mark the green areas. mark the green areas. Green areas are marked. Why you are marking the green areas? Because the green areas are having chlorophyll in them. Since it is variegated leaf, wherever the green color is there, there only chlorophyll is present. So you are marking the green areas and you are tracing them on a sheet of paper. Trace these green areas on a sheet of a paper. Right? Now, dip the leaf in boiling water for a few minutes. Dip the leaf. In boiling water. For few minutes. This is very, very interesting point. Why are we dipping this leaf in boiling water for few minutes? The boiling water make the plant cells to die so that all the metabolic activities will get arrested. Once the cells are dead, no more metabolic activities in the cells of that leaf. But whatever the glucose is synthesized, the starch is there, it all will not be getting used up now. If the plant is alive and there is starch or glucose is there, and if plant is not able to synthesize any more glucose, whatever the stored carbohydrate is there, that will get used up. But if the plant leaf cells are already dead now, as you have kept them in boiling water, all the metabolic activities are arrested. Right. Dipping the leaf in boiling water make the cells to die. So metabolic activities get arrested. Right? Now take out the leaf, immerse it in a beaker containing alcohol. So after dipping the leaf in the boiling water, take out the leaf. Now immerse this leaf in a beaker containing alcohol. Leaf has to be immersed. The leaf containing alcohol. Why are we dipping the leaf or immersing the leaf in a beaker that is containing alcohol? Immerse the leaf in a beaker. Simply why to write in a beaker all the things? In alcohol. Immerse the leaf in alcohol. Right. So, dipping the leaf in boiling water, there is a purpose to make the cells to die. And immersing the leaf in alcohol, what is the purpose? Chlorophyll gets dissolved. Chlorophyll gets dissolved. Means, whatever the chlorophyll present in the leaf, it gets dissolved in the alcohol. Why it could not dissolve in water, that too boiling water? Because chlorophyll is not soluble in water, whereas it is soluble in alcohol. So it gets dissolved in only alcohol. Why don't we do it directly by keeping the leaf in alcohol? Why we have to keep the leaf first in boiling water? Because our first purpose is to make the leaf cells get arrested from their metabolic activity. So we are doing it. Then why we have to just dissolve this chlorophyll? Actually, our main intention is chlorophyll is essential for photosynthesis. We have to prove that one. If chlorophyll is dissolved in alcohol, how can you prove it? For that, we have already marked the chlorophyll containing regions. And we have traced it on a sheet of paper also. Okay. So by keeping the leaf on a paper, if like this, we have marked on the sheet of paper. So after experiment is over, again we will keep the same traced area. The leaf will be kept in the same traced area on the paper. So we can easily come to know where the chlorophyll was present. Right. But why are we dissolving the chlorophyll? That is the purpose. Immersing the leaf in alcohol makes the chlorophyll to get dissolved. That is okay. Why chlorophyll has to get dissolved? If it is present, if chlorophyll is going to be present in the leaf itself, what will be the problem? If chlorophyll is going to be present in the leaf, it will hinder or it will disturb our experiment in the next step. What is the next step? Okay. So when the chlorophyll is getting dissolved in the alcohol containing beaker, what will be the color of that solution? Chlorophyll is in green color. As it is getting dissolved, that alcohol also will become, or it will be getting a green color. So what happens to the color of the leaf? The color of the leaf will be getting discolored and the solution will become green color. Okay. Right? But is it going to happen directly? If you keep the leaf in alcohol, directly will that chlorophyll get dissolved? No. This alcohol containing beaker, must be placed in a water bath. Alcohol containing beaker must be placed in water bath, Water bath means a special setup in which water is present and that water can be heated with our needed temperature. To our needed temperature levels, we can heat that water. And when something is kept in that water, whatever the temperature that the water is having, same temperature is transferred to that substance. Now, we are keeping alcohol containing beaker in which the leaf was already immersed. Alcohol containing beaker in which the leaf was immersed. This is kept in water bath. Some knobs will be there, which we can just, okay, with a power plug connection, everything will be there for it. Right. switch. Okay, so when this water bath is heated, this alcohol also gets heated. Once the alcohol gets heated, the chlorophyll present in the leaf will be getting dissolved and the leaf will be getting discolored and the alcohol will be getting green color. Right? Now, take out the leaf. Take out the leaf and rinse off. Sorry. Now, take out the leaf from this beaker and dip the leaf in a solution, dilute solution of iodine for few minutes. Dilute solution of iodine. So, iodine solution, you take it in a beaker. You have kept iodine solution in it. In this, you put the leaf. For few minutes. Now, after few minutes, take out the leaf. Take out the leaf. And rinse it off. Just shake the leaf like this. Okay. Rinse the leaf. What will happen? Rinse the leaf from iodine solution. Observe the color of the leaf and compare this color of the leaf with the tracing of the leaf done on the beginning. In the beginning only we have done tracing of this leaf on a paper. So compare it. What can you observe? If we compare the tracing of the leaf on that paper, wherever earlier there was green color, there only you can see the blue-black color formation. In other areas, you can see no color formation. There is no color. And why? Where there was earlier chlorophyll, in that area only the blue-black color was formed, because chlorophyll can capture the light energy and there itself the photosynthesis takes place. There itself the glucose is formed and that glucose is got converted into starch and stored in the leaf. So where earlier there was chlorophyll, there the photosynthesis has taken place, glucose is formed and the glucose is converted into starch and was stored in that area. In other parts, as there is no chlorophyll, no photosynthesis has taken place and no glucose, no starch, nothing. So there was no positive test with the iodine solution. This proves that chlorophyll is essential for photosynthesis. In this experiment, you need to remember, first thing is, take a potted plant with variegated leaves and you need to keep this plant under dark room for 3 days so that entire starch will be getting used up. Question number one, why the plant has to be kept in dark room for 3 days? So that entire starch can be getting used up. And after that, you take out the potted plant and keep it under sunlight for about 6 hours. You should not keep for more time, because if you keep for more time, more photosynthesis takes place and the extra glucose, extra starch that is synthesized or converted into starch form, it will be transferred to the non-green parts also, so that we are just keeping the plant under the sunlight for only 6 hours. Then you are plucking out the leaf. And you must take care that metabolic activities must get arrested so that you are keeping this leaf in boiling water. Metabolic activities of the cells of the leaf will be getting arrested so that starch will not get used up in the chlorophyll containing area. But if the chlorophyll is present, iodine test will not be given by that leaf, because chlorophyll will hinder with iodine test. So you need to remove this chlorophyll. But before that, you need to mark it. So you have already done that marking on a tracing paper. Chlorophyll containing regions are already marked on a tracing paper. Right. Now, when you keep this leaf in alcohol containing beaker, and later if you are keeping this alcohol containing beaker, already the leaf was immersed in it. Okay, if you keep this alcohol containing beaker in a water bath and heat it, then in heating alcohol, the chlorophyll gets dissolved and leaf will be getting discolored and alcohol will be getting green color. Alcohol will be getting green color and leaf will be getting discolored. Now, take the leaf out from the alcohol containing beaker and put it in iodine solution containing beaker for a few minutes. Then, rinse off the iodine solution by taking the leaf out from the iodine solution containing beaker. And if you observe it, where earlier there was chlorophyll, there you can see blue-black color formation. It shows that chlorophyll is essential for photosynthesis, because of which in chlorophyll containing regions only blue-black color formation has taken place. In non-chlorophyll regions, there is no blue-black color formation. Other experiments, let us discuss in the coming classes. Thank you.